Hi, this is Connie Francis, and you're listening to my dear friend, Ron Roberts.
Hello everyone, and thank you for joining me. This is Ron Roberts in London, welcoming you to a very special tribute show to Britain's premier songwriter, composer, arranger, conductor, pianist and producer, Les Reed OBE.
My baby whispers in my ear.
Sigh, a sigh for me. Don't ever cry for me. This is goodbye for me. I know it's through. I'm losing you.
A dum dum, a diddly dum. A diddly dum, oh yeah, dum dum, a diddly dum. Oh, break it, to me gently. Give me time, or give me a little time to ease the pain. Love me just a little longer. 'Cause I'll never, never love again.
Opening our show today with the million-selling sounds of Miss Dynamite, Brenda Lee. From her first US hit, One Step at a Time, way back in 1957, to the 17th chart re-entry for Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree 62 years later, the remarkable Brenda had placed 90 titles in the Billboard Hot 100 country and easy listening charts. It was my great pleasure to chat with Brenda last month, during which I asked her a couple of questions relating to her recordings of Les Reed songs. You recorded two of Les's songs, It's Not Unusual and There's a Kind of Hush. What was it that attracted you to them?
Well, I think what attracted me to them was that they were just really good, good songs. Melody, word-wise, everything that had a hook that stuck in your mind. And I think that that's been proven because they've withstood the test of time and folks still know them and listen to them and love them.
Did you record any other of his songs?
You know, I made it a practice to never look at who wrote what.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so that I would not be partial.
I'm with you, yeah.
Because that happened a lot. And I just listened to the song, and if the song was good, then I did it. I didn't want to know who wrote it. Of course, later on I knew, but when I was choosing songs, I didn't want to know.
It's not unusual. you want to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But when I see you hanging about anyone, it's not unusual to see me cry. I wanna die. It's not unusual to go out at any time. But when I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever want to be loved by anyone, it's not unusual. It happens every day. No matter what you say, you'll find it happens all the time. Love will never do what you want it to. Why can't this crazy love be mine? It's not unusual to be mad at anyone. It's not unusual to be sad with anyone. But if I find that you have changed at any time, it's not unusual to find that I'm in love with you. Whoa, 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 whoa.
It had to have been Tom Jones, of course, who attracted you to that song. What about There's a Kind of Hush? Was it the Herman's Hermits version?
Yes. I love the Hermits version. They were precious.
Well, Brenda, I'd like to thank you for taking time out to provide my listeners with your thoughts on Les. Is there anything else you would like to add?
Well, I tell you, we need more Les Reeds in the world. I just think the world is a better place because he lived in it and gave us his talent and shared it with us.
Brenda, thank you so much. I really do appreciate that.
Thank you so much. Nice to talk to you. Have a great day.
And you, Brenda.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
There's a kind of hush all over the world tonight. All over the world, you can hear the sounds of lovers in love. You know what I mean, just the two of us and nobody else in sight. There's nobody else, and I'm feeling good holding you. Now listen, listen carefully, closer now and you will see what I mean. It isn't a dream. The only sound that you will hear is when I whisper in your ear, I love you. Gonna hear the sounds of lovers in love. Hear the
Hello, this is Valerie Masters here. How lovely to spend this evening with Ron Roberts and all of you listeners.
Someone else's baby, someone else's eyes are blue. Someone else's baby, someone else's faffer too. Oh, who's got a hold of 9-carat gold, love? I wonder who's in the love seat. Who's got a heartbeat like thunder?
Just played were extracts from the high-flying spring 1960 sounds of Adam Faith with Someone Else's Boy and the top female record star of the day, Connie Francis, with Robot Man. Connie was in Britain to promote her recording and instantly formed a strong friendship with Adam, who, chart-wise, could also do no wrong.
Tell me, please, Mr. Love, will I find him tomorrow? Do your best, Mr. Love, I'll be waiting till then. Don't you know, Mr. Love, I can't take all this sorrow. So if you have the time, you'll be mine once again. Please, 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 Mr. Love, where is the boy that I'm dreaming of? Please, 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 Mr. Love, bring him back home to me. Yesterday was so fine, with him walking beside me. And he said he'd be mine till the day we both died. But he left me last night, and my heart broke inside me. I was feeling so sad that I broke down and cried. Please, 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 Mr. Love, where is the boy that I'm dreaming of? Please, 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 Mr. Love, bring him back home to me.
was Mr. Love, written by Les and Barry Mason, and which Connie was the first to record. This lilting number was one of 10 songs recorded by her at Les's Wessex studio for the album Connie Francis Sings the Songs of Les Reed. Sessions for the album took place in September 1969 on the 6th, 8th and 9th, with final overdubs on the 25th. This would turn out to be her final collection for MGM Records, with whom she had been under contract since 1955. Connie and Les had first met backstage at a May 1960 Adam Faith show, to which she had been invited. At the time, Les was pianist with the John Barry Seven, and their first encounter was when Connie handed him and Adam cups of tea. Sadly, there was no photographer around, and camera phones had yet to be invented. Here's Connie, somewhat hoarse, having just recovered from a cold, with her own thoughts and recollections, recorded much earlier in the year before the COVID-19 outbreak.
I first met Les in 1959 during one of my early trips to Britain. At the time, he was a pianist with the John Barry Seven, a popular UK instrumental group both as a recording act in their own right or as accompanying musicians for a mutual dear friend, Adam Faith, on stage and on his best-selling disc. One of my earliest recollections was when I met Adam after one of his performances. I fetched drinks for both him and a friend as they relaxed following their show, and it wasn't until much later that I learned that that friend had been Les. How could I have known that within a short period of time, Les and group leader John Barry would become giants in the industry, and that I would eagerly record their songs?
I wondered, should I go or should I stay? The band had only one more song to play, and then I saw you at the corner of my eye. Just a girl alone and so shy.
With you. Hi there, Ron. This is PJ Proby, thanking one and all for tuning in to the wonderful program you've just done on Les Reed.
While It's Not Unusual was one of the songs that made Connie and many other artists sit up and take note of Les Reed, Engelbert Humperdinck's huge success, The Last Waltz, made her appreciate how much in tune was Les with her own musical tastes. It was, however, Petula Clark's success with Kiss Me Goodbye that caused Connie to consider recording an album devoted to Les's songs. Although Connie had been a frequent visitor to Britain, she and Les did not meet again until 1969, after MGM Records president Arnold Maxin had approached him to determine if he would like to write and produce an album for the label's most successful artist. Les, with wife June and daughter Donna, spent a week in New York, during which time he and Connie started planning the album containing 10 of his songs.
You're feeling sad, I can tell. what's on your mind. My heart is breaking as well, but darling, don't say a word. Just kiss me, for soon we must part. And
Kiss me.